There has been major leaps recently in AI image generation technology, and the only natural response to this is, can we bring this to Blender? Well, as of last week, the answer is yes. Software developer and 3D artist Carson Catry has whipped together a brand new Blender add-on that allows you to generate your own textures from scratch, perfectly tiled, for free, on your local computer using AI. It's funny because the first thing I thought when I saw this add-on was Polyfured's video on Stable Diffusion and how he specifically requested to build this add-on that would bring Stable Diffusion to Blender to auto-generate textures. And that was less than a month ago. And so I've been actually chatting with Carson, and it turns out it's a complete coincidence that he happened to make this right after that video. Someone on Reddit sent him the link afterwards and he's like, wow, like what are the chances? But to be fair, Stable Diffusion has really been blowing up these days, so it was bound to happen at some point regardless. Carson told me apparently he was actually originally just playing around with Lincoln Stein's fork of Stable Diffusion called Invoke AI, and basically this fork adds a bunch of extra features and options on top of the original Stable Diffusion implementation. For example, one thing you can do is you can actually run the Stable Diffusion algorithm using as little as 4 gigs of video RAM, which is kind of unheard of when it comes to this stuff. His add-on even came with a nice little web server where you can basically just open your browser and generate it there. But of course that wasn't good enough. We got to bring this to Blender. Thank you, Carson, for doing that. And today we're going to take a look at it. So back to the add-on. One thing I'm going to say right away is the thing about cutting-edge technology is it's cutting edge, and you might get cut. But for real, even though all three operating systems are supported for this tool, today it will only really run on Apple Silicon, so if you have an M1 or M2 chip, or an NVIDIA-based graphics card, which, like I said, needs at least 4 gigs of VRAM within it. And I haven't tested this myself, but I'm pretty sure you need at least a 10 series and above. They also do recommend having at least 12 gigs of regular RAM. I haven't tried this under 12 gigs, but you can if you want. Your mileage may vary. You also need a decent chunk of disk space to download all the dependencies and models, around 6 gigabytes for that. To be fair though, if you've been following any kind of AI tech, you shouldn't be surprised by that. Models have been trained on millions of images, so naturally this file is gonna be quite big, but of course well worth it for the fact that you can actually just run this right on your computer, which is pretty incredible. In addition to this, you will need to go through a couple steps to download all those dependencies and that model. It takes a little bit longer than you might with some other add-ons, but don't give up. I'll do it with you today and it's worth it. By the way, I forgot to mention, this plugin is based off of Lincoln Stein Invoke AI plugin. As you can see, the plugin literally references the Invoke AI repository here. I think it's just worth mentioning that so that you know how this is actually built under the hood. So let's get started. The first thing you're going to want to do is download the add-on, of course. To do that, you can come down here and click on download the latest version, or if you want to see all the versions, you can come here to releases and you'll see them all here. You'll need to expand the assets and you want to download the zip file. Now, as of recording this video, this isn't completely up to date. Since 0.0.5, they've actually improved a lot of the UI, including making it appear in a tab view, which I'll show you shortly. If you want the latest and greatest, you can, but it's going to be a little bit more work. If you're familiar with GitHub, you can do cloning. There is this download zip button, but this will not work, so don't try that. The reason why it won't work is because what I was talking about earlier, this Stable Diffusion repository that this references is a submodule, and if you just download the zip, that submodule will not be included. So if you're familiar with Git, you can go ahead and clone that, and you'll have to do a submodule init and update. I'm not going to go into that right now, but if that's something that you're interested in, just leave a comment and I can help you out with that. So we'll go ahead and download the latest. We're going to open Blender Preferences, go to our add-ons and install that zip file. We're going to enable that add-on, open it up, and before we do anything at all, including install the dependencies, we need to actually restart Blender first. And the reason for that is because we actually need to run Blender as an administrator. This is a requirement on Windows. If you're not on Windows, then no worries. We will open our preferences back up again and search for the Dream Textures add-on, expand that guy, and now we can go ahead and install the dependencies. This will take a little while. I'll just fast forward here. When you're done that, you can go ahead and scroll down to the area where we'll download the weights. You'll be brought to a website called Hugging Face where you can download the weights. You will need to create an account. It's free, but this is required in order to download the file. After downloading, you'll come back and open the directory where it needs to have that file stored, and then find that file you downloaded, and you need to rename it to model.ckpt, and then simply take that file and drag it into our target folder. And that is literally it. Come back to Blender. You'll need to restart Blender just one more time, and then you'll see a button called validate. Go ahead and click that, and if all goes well, it will show a check mark there. By the way, real quick, I have to mention, if you're on Windows, you may encounter an issue installing dependencies. I actually came across this when I was trying to set it up, and turns out on Windows, there's actually like a maximum file path length. So if you have enough folders deep enough with file names that are long enough, Windows will actually struggle to fetch files from your file system if it's too long. But there is a solution to this. I discovered basically you need to go into your registry. So you go start, run, type in regedit. And if you drill through H key local machine system current control set control and then file system, there's a setting for long pass enabled. If you're having the problem, that's probably set to 0. So go ahead and change that to 1. You will need to restart your computer, open Blender back up and reinstall those dependencies, and you should be good to go. If you're on Mac or Linux, thanks for bearing with me. And okay, let's get back to the plugin. So one way to use this is to go ahead and head on over to your image editor. And then from there, you can hit the arrow on the right-hand side or N on your keyboard and head on over to the Dream tab. And this is where it gets fun. We can search for any subject we want. So in this case, let's search for brick. We want to turn the seamless option on so that our generated texture is perfectly tiled on all sides. We'll hit generate, and at this point in time, you will get a little bit of lag. Most likely what's happening is the add-on is actually loading the entire model into your memory right now. So expect this to take a little bit of time the first time, but then all future times should be quite a bit quicker. Next, you'll see what basically looks like a whole bunch of noise eventually kind of converging into an image. I'm speeding this video up about 8 times, so expect it to take a lot longer. At least I'm running this on a 1070, which is obviously not super modern. On a more modern NVIDIA GPU, you can probably expect quicker times. But for this video, I'll just speed it all up so you guys aren't waiting. And then from there, to prove that this is tiling perfectly, we can head on over to View and then click on Repeat Image. And you can see when we check that off, you can see this thing tiling in all directions. Pretty freaking cool. So yeah, use your creative freedom here. Let's make this a yellow brick, see what happens. Okay, not quite sure what kind of brick that is. What you can do with this, by the way, is just regenerate it over and over again. Each time this runs, it's actually running on what you call a random seed. The seed is like how it decides what that noise is going to look like originally. So it'll produce a random seed each time if you let it. So just clicking regenerate will create a brand new image each time. By the way, these are all just saved as images within Blender. So you can go ahead and click on that drop down and you go back and see all of your previously generated images. They're all there. They are all packed by default, by the way, which means they're embedded within the Blender file. So just keep that in mind. You may or may not want to take those out into a different folder. We can keep playing around. Let's try to make some cement. Okay, I'm not in love with this cement. And here's the thing, guys, is a lot of times you're going to get bad results. And the reality is you just got to keep trying. And sometimes you got to be very intentional about your text input. For example, sometimes I found that adding the word texture or close up can help. So for example, let's try orange peel texture. Okay, I take that back. That's not quite what we were looking for. I mean, it still looks pretty cool. Oh, by the way, we can also change our sampler. So feel free to play around with these different sampler algorithms. As we can see, that didn't do much for us here. So really, our subject line is really what's most important. Let's try close up. And is that an orange peel? I'm not sure. Is that maybe super zoomed in? Looks kind of like gelato maybe. Let's try something else. Let's try a raspberry close up. And there are our raspberries. I was hoping to get more of like a raspberry texture for a single raspberry. I think would be more useful, but this is still kind of cool. Like I said, guys, this is brand new stuff. So don't expect at this point in time for it to be perfect. Everything's still getting refined and improved. By the way, I should mention the actual name of each of these images. As you can see, there are these random numbers. This number is actually the randomly generated seed that the add-on used to generate this image. And like I talked about, seeds decide what is that initial noise and then how it will turn into the final image. So what you can actually do is you can basically pass that exact same seed number and with the exact same subject prompt and settings, and you can actually regenerate the identical image each time. And I'll prove that right now. So as you can see, it looks the same. If I open up the first one, they're identical. Let's change that back to -1, which means choose a random seed. In future versions, by the way, it won't be -1. It'll just be a separate checkbox, which is nice. What else can we make? Maybe let's do a roof tile. Cool beans. I'm sure we could keep refining this if we wanted to. We could also maybe do like a leaf close up. By the way, I should have mentioned earlier, you can see at the top there how the actual progress of this generation, it actually does 25 steps, which is actually a setting that you can change. So as it's generating, you can see what step it's on. Now let's move on over to the shading tab where we can actually make use of these textures. To do this, we'll add an image texture, and I'll go through this quick. If this is all new to you, I'll make a whole nother video, but you can just pass that image texture right in there. And of course, as we'd expect, we can actually get the image to map right onto that surface. And if we want to change like the scale, we'd add a texture coordinate and mapping node. Again, I'll go over all this stuff in another video if this is brand new to you, but otherwise you should be familiar with all of this stuff. So this is pretty cool. And by the way, the Dream texture add-on is also available within the shader tab, so you can actually just access it here as well. What will happen is when you create a new prompt and generate it, it will show on the left-hand side there. That's just the image editor again, but then it will pop it into the current shader conveniently for us. And we can just take that new node, image texture node, and pipe that right in. Of course, this pumpkin texture isn't as useful as I was hoping it would be. Let's try close up. Looks kind of like a tiger. Let's do it again. I have no idea what that is. One thing I have had good results with is fabric. So if we search for heathered gray fabric, for example, there's our fabric, and we can actually just delete this and find it. And this one might be a little bit quicker. There it is. Probably we'd want to scale this down just a little bit. But yeah, not bad. Now, another thing you might do here is add a bump map. This isn't probably the most technical way to do this, but at a super high level, you could just pass this texture into the height property of a bump map, pass it into your normals, and now you actually can get a little bit of that bump. There's more advanced ways to do this, but this is just like a super quick and dirty way. Another thing worth mentioning is you can change the actual output size of this texture. Now, beware that the larger you go, the longer it's going to take. In this case, 1024 by 1024 takes my GPU a very long time to generate, more than double, probably more than four times as well. It essentially has to quadruple the number of pixels to generate, right? Also, there will be a maximum size you can make depending on how much RAM your GPU provides. For me, I wasn't actually able to generate anything larger than 1024 by 1024. I would get an error that said that my GPU ran out of RAM. So just keep that in mind. I'll fast forward this for you guys. There's our texture. So what I'm gonna do next is I'm gonna go back to our image editor. I'm going to turn off our repeat image setting, and I'm going to show you some other options here. So before we were on the texture preset, but there's actually some other types of images we can create. Now from a Blender perspective, I'd say these are probably less useful, but still could be useful in certain situations. Perhaps you could provide environment textures here, or maybe some sort of photograph for some situation. But at this point, we can just have some fun playing around with stable diffusion itself and just kind of show you guys what else this thing can do. So here you can see there's a bunch of different settings. We got low angle, full color, shallow depth of field. Let's make this an outdoor photograph at golden hour of lighting. So you kind of get that full control here. And yeah, let's make a dinosaur. Oh, and let's turn her size back to 512 by 512. Wow, guys, really don't know what that was. Looks like it's from the upside down, maybe. Let's try again. By the way, we forgot to turn seamless off, because right now it's still, even though it's a photograph and not a texture, it's still trying to create a seamless image. That maybe was one reason why that looked so crazy. So let's turn that off. Sweet, not bad. Let's add some spice. Let's do a dinosaur with a cowboy hat. And maybe let's do more of a long shot. And maybe more of that fast shutter speed. All right, so not quite sure what kind of dinosaur that is. Let's try an astronaut with the cowboy hat. And now we're missing the cowboy hat. Like I said, the subject line is so important to get right here. Okay, I'm struggling here. At this point in time, I think this stuff really takes some finessing. Maybe someday it's going to be a full-time job for people who are experts at the exact right keywords to generate the proper AI images. Just like, as you know, as a skill to Google search something, this will be the exact same thing. Okay, so we got both an astronaut and a lasso this time. I think he's kind of holding that. That perspective is kind of weird, but I think that was better because we were specific. So let's try being specific. Astronaut riding a horse. Okay, I'll take that. By the way, there's more than just photography. There's another option here called concept art, where you can actually choose the subject type. So let's do a character, the genre, the concept artist. That's the style of the artist you want to generate. And guys, I think that's the best one we've had yet. Look at that. This is actually quite incredible. It's really, I mean, we're just clicking buttons like this is normal. This is actually extremely impressive at the end of the day, right? I think this is our best one yet. So sometimes you just got to be persistent and keep trying and kind of finesse your settings until you eventually get what you want. Now, this plugin has seen lots of updates already in the last couple days. For example, since recording this video, there's already been changes to the way seed generation works. So instead of -1, like I was showing before, that represents a random seed, there's actually just a nice checkbox that says random seed or not, which is pretty cool. There's also a bug with the seed where some seed numbers that were too large wouldn't actually work in it, as it was capped to, I think, the size of a 32-bit integer signed. Anyways, looks like that's fixed as well. And if you're watching this video even a week from now, there's probably a whole bunch of new changes. So props to Carson and all the other contributors who have helped out making this plugin awesome. One feature we might see in the future, by the way, is an upscaling feature. This feature was never completely promised, but it's definitely been talked about, where, as we talked about before, you can only generate images as large as your graphics card can support. In my case, it was 1024x1024. If you want anything bigger than that, then you're kind of out of luck, unless you use another AI technology called upscaling. And if you're familiar with images at all, you know, upscaling has never been a thing. You can always downscale an image, but you can't make an image bigger than the original size, right? You can cut a 2x4, it's smaller, but you can't cut it bigger. Until recently, there's now a new AI technology called upscaling, where it actually uses AI trained with a whole bunch of images to basically allow you to grow your image larger than what it originally was and basically do its best guess to fill in those empty pixels. It's not perfect by any means. I played around with the technology a little bit, and there can be some okay results. I'm sure it'll just get better and better. So anyways, that would be super cool if we saw that in the add-on in the future. Anyways, guys, that's it for today. Thanks so much for watching. I hope to see some really cool Blender creations, perhaps using auto-generated textures. Let me know if you do have any success with this. I would love to hear about it. Thanks again, guys, and I'll catch you down the next rabbit hole.